Hello students of standard 6. Today we are going to start new chapter, chapter 10. The Happy Prince part 1. Happy Prince, what is happiness? What do you like? What do you mean by happiness? When we are joyful, when we are satisfied, we are happy. When festival comes, we are happy to celebrate. When our friend or our relatives come, we are very happy to meet them, be with them, enjoy. And also when we are with our friends in a happy moment for the play, we are happy. But here is talking about a happy prince. So, first is question for you. Work in group for the poor. Pick up against three qualities which you think can prove most effective in making our world a better place. To have the better place, what are the things needed? What are the qualities need for the happy life? Do you understand? So, we need, here are some qualities: honesty, optimism, creativity, love, charity, selflessness. So what do you think need? Mostly you think means you need one, everything. But sometimes it is needed mostly is honesty, love and selflessness. If you have honesty, you are honest, you can do everything properly. And if you have love for the others or for the work, you will be doing better, because in that there is no way to have the selfishness. Because you love and you want to do it. And with love, whatever do, it is God's grace. He helps us because we practice the love and unity. And where is love, there no selfishness will enter. No selfish character will come. You will be always selfless. So no selfishness will come. Selfish people are always greedy, want to grab something from others, only want for oneself. But if selflessness is there, you don't want. You want always give up. You want to give to the people. You want to help the others. You like to do some good things for others. That's the quality of love, honesty and selflessness. So here today's lesson is telling us, as Happy Prince stands high above the city, he can see the unhappiness and suffering of many people all around him. He wants to help them. And now find out how he is able to carry out his wish. He is telling, Happy Prince father was king and they lived on the high above on the mountain. Father was very generous, very kind to the people, and he did all good work for the people. And then after some time father died, and then son was the same. He also did everything like that. And since they were very good, see in the picture here how it shows they made the Happy Prince statue very high above, and here on the stand they have kept. And he could see the people, since high it was, so he could see the people suffering. How he suffered there and what he is going to do for the people, let us listen through the story. Here are the character shows that Happy Prince, Swallow,
women 1, 2, 3, poor man 1 and 2, mother, mayor, guard, daughter and angel. These are the character in this story.
This is a like a drama. It is given to you in the lesson to listen and learn. This is not this is not a simple a story for you. It is a moral story. The statue of Happy Prince is on a tall column. He is fully covered in gold. He has a gold heart too. His eyes are two blue sapphires. There is also a ruby in his sword. A crowd passes by, looks at the statue and leaves the scene. Mother and daughter stop it to admire it. So he's telling here, the whole thing is golden statue, fully with the gold. Even the heart is made of the gold. And he is telling that his sapphire is blue color and his ruby, a jewelry, is red color. Jewelry put in that. And statue, a crowd passes by. So from there the crowd is passing through. And mother and daughter is standing near the statue and they were admiring, looking at it, enjoying and thinking, what a magical golden thing is this. Daughter, look mother, such a beautiful statue. Do you know who he is? Sorry. So mother looked at the story. The daughter looked at the statue and said, mother, do you know who is he? What a beautiful statue it is. Mother, that is the statue of a prince. It was built many years ago. People tell different stories about him. I don't know if he was real or if he is only a legend. So mother said, this is many years ago. This statue was built and placed on this high stand. But people, many different people narrate different story about them. But I don't know how much is true. Whether is it true or it is a simply a legend. Legend means a story. Simply some people have a habit of creating a story. So whether it is a story or it is reality, I have no idea. But I have heard many stories about it. So children, always people create some story. And stories are always a story. But here mother says, many say different things. And whether it is really truth or only a story. So we will find out in the next class, what is the story behind it. Okay children, today learn the word meaning properly. And we will see you in the next class. Thank you.